Formaggio Kitchen in Cambridge is a cheese lover's paradise and has been for 40 years.
We encourage people to taste everything before they buy it because we really believe that cheese is a living, breathing thing. The next time they come in, it may taste completely different.
The international array of tastes here is over the top, in part because down below is America's first retail ripening room, or cheese cave.
We're gatekeepers. We buy great cheese from everywhere and we keep it well.
Isan Gurdal, owner and chief cheesemonger, got the idea from his European counterparts.
Everybody that we loved and admired in the business had their ripening caves or maturing caves. I started looking at this basement a little closer and found that our old office in there where I used to count money, having the perfect conditions. So I started building it one weekend very nervously.
But when Julia Child saw it,
I carried her downstairs and she said, "This is better than aged steak." And we got quoted in like 36 international magazines, and that was the beginning.
Today, customers can brave the caves and enroll in an underground cheese lesson to learn about cultural traditions in the cheesemaking world and the art of aging, affinage. General Manager, Julia Holman.
For example, this cheese right here, this is Echiola Artigasna Fermier. And you can't buy this cheese anywhere else in the United States.
In Basque, Echiola means shepherd's hut. Artigasna, sheep cheese.
To get this cheese, we have to travel to the Pyrenees. So it's up to us to convince them that we will care for their cheeses properly.
Caring for this bounty requires 9-hour cave shifts for Formaggio staff when each cheese is turned, cleaned, and rubbed.
We often bring our cheesemakers down here. This cave is so old and we've been developing the mold and bacteria in here, and it's created a perfect environment.
Below the stage of the Boston Opera House, deep in the basement, something the public never sees. Hallways of murals left behind by actors, musicians, and crew members who perform in this historic venue. A visual calling card by, say, Billy Crystal, even Barack Obama. The tradition began in 2004 when The Lion King opened the newly restored theater.
We have 3 Lion King murals back here.
Tivone Marcus is vice president of Broadway in Boston.
It's a really wonderful tradition, really rooted in the theater. Anyone who's traveling with the show, it's sort of their way of marking, I came through here and we did this show. You'll see folks who have been in many different shows that have come here many different times, and it's a little bit like a museum for them.
The murals also document significant events.
During Book of Mormon's first play here was actually during the Boston Marathon bombing, and they notated that in their mural. We had the big blizzard of 2015, dubbed as Snowmageddon, and Motown sort of notated that.
All this amazing artwork and no audience?
We are looking at possibilities of maybe doing something fun with our subscribers, so more on that to come.
Or as Billy Crystal says, "I'll see you when I see you." Here's a basement with an art collection you can visit, the Museum of Bad Art. Fittingly, it was born in a basement 25 years ago, and today the Somerville Theatre is one of 3 locations. General Manager Ian Judge.
We thought it fit in perfectly with this place. It's kind of funky. It's about art, but it doesn't take art too seriously, and I think that's kind of what Somerville is about.
Admission is the price of a movie ticket.
If you're going on an awkward date to the movies and you don't know what to talk about afterwards, there's plenty to talk about if you stop at the Museum of Bad Art.
When built a century ago, the basement had a bowling alley, billiard hall, and cafe, or speakeasy, given the era.
These are the 2 bottles we found in the ceiling when we were doing renovations. This is from the Rex Distilling Company on Causeway Street in Boston, and this is of unknown origin, but no doubt something that would rot your gut.
Today, there are 5 movie screens, 2 in the basement, live events, plenty of popcorn, and like it or not, bad art.
It doesn't really ruffle too many feathers, and those feathers that get ruffled tend to have their nose a little too high in the air anyway.
Next, a place to prepare for worst-case situations.
Cold War era command bunker for the state.